Hey guys, it's Hef. I am back again. Today I don't have any makeup on. And that is because I am going to do a two-part video, and the first part of this video is to unbox the Revolution Advent Calendar. I've left the pretty looking piece of plastic on it. This was available via Priceline, except it wasn't available via all Pricelines. It was only available in Pricelines in Australia that have the pharmacy attached to them, because not all Pricelines have a pharmacy attached to them. So I ended up ordering this online. I also ordered a Revolution Foundation and a Revolution Concealer, and I thought using the stuff that's in here and the stuff that's in the other Revolution box gift set thing that I unboxed, which had all the palette stuff in it, I am going to do a look of makeup, like face makeup stuff. So I'm going to open these all up first. I'm not going to do them one day at a time over 25 days, 24 days. It's not how I operate. So I'm going to open this up. See, it's got an actual advent calendar. And then in the second video, I will do a makeup look. Basically, full face of Revolution Beauty, pretty much. So, yeah, unless there's something that it doesn't have, obviously. Okay, so let's get into this. This was $80 in Australia, which is, you know, about normal for stuff like this in Australia. Is very large. And number one, right there. So you'll see what it is before me, sort of. Okay, they're going to make this difficult for me. It actually tells you on the back exactly what is in each thing. So first up, we have a baked highlighter. It doesn't have a name, it's just a white highlighter powder. That's pretty. So we have, and this is like the mini size, which is pretty much all you really need for highlighter. I mean, I know people keep on saying that you never really use up highlighters. I've actually used up three of them. Just saying. So number two is right here. And it's a lipstick by the look of it. Yep. This is a Revolution Amazing Lipstick. Again, it doesn't have a colour name on it, like a shade name on it. Oh, it's a bullet lipstick. And it's a nude. Nothing wrong with a nude. It's quite sheer. Let's see right there. I'm kind of getting more into wearing nude lipsticks. On the back of it, it tells you what's in each thing and an ingredients list, which is quite nice to do that. I'm going to not keep on showing you the thing because it's kind of awkward and it will take forever. So in day three, we have it's a medium brown pencil. I'm assuming it's supposed to be a brow pencil, but just use it as a brown eyeliner. It's a little on the stiff side, which is what you'd expect from an eyeliner. That one is clearly full size. The lipstick is clearly full size. The so in day four, the little compacty type things are kind of hard to get out. So this is a baking powder, so it's kind of like a banana powder. It's got that yellowy tone to it. Again, in a mini size, which is fine. Day five looks like it's going to be a loss. I haven't actually looked at the back, so I don't actually know. Oh, it looks like concealer. The problem with putting something like this in, I hope it's a primer. Oh, it's an eye primer, which means I've now got two eye primers, but that's fine. I think the other eye primer is different to this one. So eye primer, that's good. Day 6. Oh, there's a brush. So it's just a little travel-sized brush, probably for like highlighter or blush or something. Clearly synthetic, sort of soft. Not the softest brush I've ever felt, but it's not bad. Day 7. This one might be another brush. No. Primer. No. Clear lip gloss. I'm just guessing until I read it. So this is a clear lip gloss for people who just want clear lip gloss. And clearly full size lip gloss. Eye primer, clearly full size. I'm actually surprised how many of these are actually full size. Wasn't actually expecting that. The pictures I've seen online of the stuff tended to look quite like they were all minis, but they're clearly not. Another brush. I'd probably use this like for concealer or doing like a cut crease or something because it's nice and small. That's that one. That was day 8. Day 9. Day 9 looks like another lipstick. Again, it does not have a name on it. This one's more of a berry tone. This is more up my alley kind of colour. So that's pretty. None of them are like outrageous, which is probably good because not everybody wants outrageous makeup. Some people just want normal makeup. This one is either an Day 10 is either an eyeliner or a mini mascara. It's a brow gel. I was wrong again. A clear brow gel. Just a mini size, mini little clear brow gel. Also useful. Day 11. Day 11 is a bigger one. Oh, it's an eyeshadow palette. Like a travel size eyeshadow palette. Yep, they called it a mini eyeshadow palette. Oops, can't get it open. This Revolution's kind of hard to get open. So, you know, fairly everyday wearable except for that glittery grey shade in the middle. There's only one matte in there. The rest are either glittery or sort of a satin sheen. The only matte is this one here, which is kind of a contour shade, so I guess that's okay. But yeah, good for travel, I guess. You might be able to use the black as an eyeliner. Okay, I just opened one and there is nothing in there. That is weird. I think that was supposed to be the mirror. It might have slipped out of the thing. Yeah, I think it did. Hang on. Yep. basically it's just a little Revolution mirror. It's not in a compact or anything. It's just a little, blind you, sorry. It's what it is, I guess. What are you up to? 13. 13 is what looks like a bronzer or a contour. It is in fact a bronzer. Let's see there. it's not a super dark bronzer, but it's also not really something that is necessarily suitable for pasty pale people like me. 14 is another brush. This one is a angled brush. Quite stiff, which is good. So, got three little brushes so far. Day 15 is another, it's either a blush or a highlighter or a contour. Looks like a highlighter. Another pressed highlighter. This one's more champagne in colour, unlike that first one, which was, this one's a pressed highlighter, the other one's a baked highlighter. So that's the pressed highlighter. Yes. It's quite nice actually. Hey, what are we up to? 16. Is a liquid lip, full size liquid lip. Again, it doesn't have a, oh, it says lip gloss, so it doesn't have a colour name on it. That's very pigmented for a gloss. It's definitely got the kind of stick of a gloss, but it's very pigmented. 17 is potentially a blush. Guessed it right. It is in fact a pressed blush, a nice pinky kind of tone. So rather, it's pretty pigmented. You'd have to be careful. It's actually what I found with the other Revolution Beauty, the ones in the palette, because I've actually been using them quite a bit, is the blushes are really quite pigmented and you do have to be a little bit careful. So day 18 is a lip liner by the look of things. Nope, it's an eyeliner. It's in the colour of the packaging is not what the colour inside is. Oh, that is very creamy. It's just a standard black pencil eyeliner. I only have like a gazillion of those. 19 another lip gloss, I'm guessing, by Tube. No, it's a liquid highlighter. Looks exactly like the lip glosses. Oh, that's very champagne-y. Yes. Right there. I don't really use liquid highlighter very much. It's not really my jam, but I'm not complaining. 20. Looks like another bronzer. Alright, this one's a pressed contour. They're way too dark for me as a pressed contour. It's really not that much. It's not that much lighter than the bronzer is. I think with maybe a light hand you might be able to get away with it. Have to be real careful. 21 is another baked highlighter. This one is more pinky than the others. So it's hard to see. But those are the last two highlighters that we did. So three different tones of highlighter. I actually now have something like six Revolution Beauty highlighters. 22 looks like another brush. It's this weird shaped brush. I don't know what I would use it for. Maybe to use a cream product with. I don't know, because it's so long and weird in shape, and it's not fluffy or anything. It's not like a shader brush or anything. Maybe you could press eyeshadows on with it. It's a really weird shape. 23 is some kind of pencil. This one looks like a lip liner. This is in Chauffeur. It's just a nude lip liner, which is always good. Nude lip liners work. So we're getting to the last two. So A24, either a lip gloss or, well, this one is a liquid lipstick rather than a lip gloss, in some bright red colour. Running out of space on my hand. Wow. It's like really red. Like really, really red. That's it. I like it. And day 25, because this is a 25-day advent calendar, not a 24-day one like most of the time, is actually a full-size palette. A full-size 15-pan palette, which is... Oh, apparently that weird-shaped brush is supposed to be a foundation and concealer brush. This is the Reloaded Fire palette. That's what this one is. So it's got some nice purple tones in it. It's got mattes, shimmers. None of them are like super-duper glittery. There's a couple that have got sort of glitter in them, but they're not like full-on glitter. There's a really good mix of mattes and shimmery kinds of shades in there. So that's interesting. Yeah. So, I mean, I think for... this would probably retail around 20 Australian dollars. Plus... I'm sure these are probably 15, something like that. I'm not 100% sure. But with... You get... let's see. Whoopsie. you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 full-size products. And then the rest of them are... minis, travel size, or brushes. So I think that's actually pretty good for $80. Not complaining at all. Yeah, so I'm pretty happy with that. It's a good way, I think, to try out Revolution Beauty and see whether you like it or not before you spend your monies on it. Or, like, get more specific about stuff. Yeah. So that's it for part one of this Revolution Christmas video. In part two, I am going to do an eye look. So I will see you in that video. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there, click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup type videos and unboxings, and leave me a comment down below. I will at least like your comment, and I will attempt to ask any questions that you answer. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.